Good morning, friends. blessings and tidings to you on the 22nd of May, 2022. Yeah, that's right. as always, my name is Pastor Drew McCaffrey, serving here at Bethany. I do apologize for the uniqueness of today's message. this past week, we took part in the Festival of Homiletics, which I'll talk a little bit more about that during the reflection time. But unfortunately, my wife contracted COVID in the process. Even though we were with only a handful of clergy down at Camp Sequinota, but due to some various circumstances, we still had to come back up in the Altoona area to do clergy calls and things like that, and that may be one of the places where she contacted. We're not fully sure, but due to that, I am unfortunately not gathered in worship with you today, so I do apologize for that, but hopefully in this unique time together, it will still be one that is spiritually uplifting. This is going to be recorded and shown on our upcoming YouTube page, which is going to be tied in with our live streaming services, and we're almost there. That's the best I can say. But what I can say for those who do take part in our YouTube channel here, do like and subscribe to it. That way, you can receive future content, hopefully with live stream services or special messages that will be in the future. But enough of those announcements. Let us join together in our time. Our message today comes from John's Gospel in the 14th chapter, starting at the 23rd verse. Jesus answered, "Judas, not Iscariot, those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words, and the word that you hear is not mine, but is from the Father who sent me. I have said these things to you while I am still with you, but the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. You heard me say to you, I am going away, and I am coming to you. If you loved me, you would rejoice that I am going to the Father, because the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it occurs, so when it does occur, you may believe." It's the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Again, I mentioned earlier in the messages, but I will say it again. This past week, my wife, myself, and a couple other pastors that we are known through, you know, in our synod, we met down at Camp Sequinota in Somerset County, to where we shared fellowship, but also we gathered to partake in the Festival of Homiletics. Now, for you've heard me talk about the Festival of Homiletics, numerous encounters. For those who haven't, this is a annual preaching conference, a week-long conference to where you hear sermons and presentations from a variety of preachers and scholars in most of the mainline traditions. You know, we had some UCC members, we had chaplains from large universities, we had scholars from different seminaries, we had bishops, and a variety of different individuals. And the theme this year was Preaching the Storm, which sounds exciting, is the best way to put it. Many of the speakers spoke of what preaching is like in the realms of COVID, which I know for many of us feels like beating on a broken drum, repeating a tired old record. It's still a real thing for many of us. But some of the speakers also spoke about preaching, going into, through, and in the midst of the storms with the civic disrest, the political realms, and just the worldly things going on around us. And I would be lying if I didn't say it was a heavy week. Things got a little fuzzy after mid-Wednesday with some of the presentations. And unfortunately, some of that's going to be is recorded and we'll be rewatching to spiritually digest with that at a later time. But I think for many of us, there's just a heaviness of what's going on around us. And as we reminded through the various speakers throughout this week, there is just a unease and disheartening that is among us, not only as preachers of the word, but also those of us of the faith, the Christian faith, or any faith, really, to where we've been impacted in so many different ways. And the vignette, or the thin line through all of that, was this continued reminder that we are in this together. We are not alone. It is something that is, we are all in the trenches. We are all in the midst of the storm. And we wonder, is there ever going to be a sense of feeling we have come out of that storm, but not only come out of that storm, but to where we're feeling the sunshine on us, the clouds are clear, you know, maybe you're seeing the rainbow, to where everything just feels perfect once again. Unfortunately, some of the speakers did not touch on that. So, I guess because for some of us, we still feel in the eye of the hurricane. And we long for that well-being, that hopefulness. And it's no different for the disciples. Again, gathered in the upper room, we are, as we come to an end of this Easter season, celebrating in the resurrection, but for our gospel lesson, we're still in that upper room. We're still Monday, Thursday mode. Jesus, again, is still trying to instill what is to come. And the disciples still in that fuzzy haziness, that sense of dealing with the storm that is about to ensue in them, and they don't know what that's going to look like to the full extent. But Jesus is reminding them, you know, something is coming else for me. Of course, Jesus is talking about the crucifixion. Jesus is also trying to instill on the disciples that there will be a day where Jesus is with the Father. Jesus is with God. Jesus is not going to be that safety net for the disciples. Instead, someone else is going to be with them. Something else, depending how you want to look at it. The great advocate, the Holy Spirit, that one part of the Trinity we as Lutherans sort of have such a sense of confusion about. But it is because of that advocate, because of that spirit, because of that other piece of the Trinity that reminds us that the message of Jesus, the message of Christ, the sense of hope that is we are all longing and awaiting for is present but also will continue, will come. I know for some of us it's really hard right now because for whatever storm you are experiencing in your life, whatever sense of darkness is looming or has been looming for some time, it truly feels like we're in this solo, and daggone it, we wish God was here to fix this. But unfortunately, our faith is just not that easy. You know, we want things to be easier, we want things to be simpler, we want it to be better, but it's not in some cases. Jesus says, not only will you receive and experience the Holy Spirit, because remember, Pentecost is around the corner, and when Pentecost came, the disciples were still in the room. They still were at a sense of unease because the loomingness that is happening. But it is that gift which Jesus continues to give to his disciples, is that gift that the Spirit gives to them. It is also the same gift the Spirit gives to us. And that is the gift of peace. Or is the other gift, the other way of phrasing it, the gift of shalom. Which, for those who don't have never really took notice, you really can't see it very well on the camera. I'm sorry for that. But I got that tattooed on my wrist. Because I think for many of us, we want the gift of shalom. We want the gift of peace, because it's not just, you know, like the sharing of peace we do during worship. It's not like just the peace signs we see splattered on someone's car or somewhere else, but the peace that Jesus leaves, the gift of shalom, is this sense of well-being that only God can give. The sense of well-being and acknowledgement that through everything, through the good times, and also the crap, the storms, the mud, whatever you want to name it. In through that, God is in the midst. God is the one who will pick us up, dust us off a little bit, wipe our face, and say, well, we hit the mud hole in the journey. Let's keep walking, and hopefully we'll see the next one coming. So friends, as we gather in the midst of the storms of our lives, as you know, what we're doing here, you know, in my house right now, the question is how COVID's going to impact our house. You know, hopefully some of the things that my wife is dealing with is on the lower scale. She's still dealing with some of the symptoms, but the question is, will I also come down with COVID? How will COVID continue to impact us? How will the civil and political unrest that is going on around us continue to stir us? How will the personal demons that keep poking and prodding at us still strike us? How will everything that just weighs us down keep at it? Hopefully you were reminded that through the Spirit, through the ever-changing sense of hope and shalom, call out to you and remind you that you are not alone in all this, that God is with you and God will continue to be with you. And hopefully, in the midst of feeling that sense of not alone, we will continue to remind others within our community, within our surroundings, of that same shalom. And who knows that maybe it will become a greater change than we can ever imagine. So until then, friends, may you receive the peace of Christ, who is understanding and who is with us always. And for that, we can say thanks be to God. And amen.